work next 24 months, next 2 years, you are the most successful person in your life, no doubt. You are the most successful in your family also, no doubt. So this PUC, especially science, PCMB, very important. Why? Because in 10th class you study with just 6 subjects, 3 subjects along with 3 subjects, 3 languages, Kannada, English, Hindi. But in PUC, not like that. Almost all 11 tracks are there. PCMB, 4 subjects along with 2 languages. You can choose either Kannada or Hindi along with English, 2 languages. And 3 practical examinations, 3 practicals will go, that is separate track. And entrance examination, if you opt engineering, JEE, that means maths, physics, chemistry. If you opt NEET, so medical entrance examination, then we have to work hard on biology, physics, chemistry. So 4 core subjects, 2 languages, 3 practical examinations and 3 entrance examinations. So almost all you have to work on 11 or 12 tracks. So it is the double of your 10th class schedule. So next to 20, not even 24 months, except always you get that hardly 17-18 months. If you work these 17-18 months, next 70-80 years of your life will be settled. You can enjoy your next 70-80 years of life. If you work just 17 months, note it. Yes. SGM Independent View College, Chitradurga. My subject is, we already discussed this, mathematics. Mathematics. Mathematics divided into 4 parts along with some dry parts, along with some other parts. The first one is algebra. The first one is algebra. Second one is trigonometry. Second one is trigonometry. Third one is geometry. Third one is geometry. Next, fourth one is calculus. Fourth one is calculus. Along with these all 4, some topics are there like statistics. Statistics. Probability, statistics, probability, mathematical reasoning. So these topics we cannot include either in algebra or trigonometry or geometry or calculus. Calculus. If you are preparing for JEE exam or KCET, engineering entrance examination, algebra and calculus are very important. Most number of problems every time from these 2 parts, algebra and calculus. Of course, these 2 also important, but very least weightage compared to algebra and calculus. So, mathematics divided into 4 parts along with some dry parts like statistics, but that is also included in your 10th class. First PUC, in first PUC, the statistics is there, that is the expansion of your 10th class syllabus. It's a very easy problem. Statistics, probability also included in your state syllabus. No problem. Next, mathematical reasoning is the new thing, that is very easy. Yes, these 4 are the major parts of the mathematics. First PUC or second PUC. In first PUC, more number of topics from algebra and geometry. But in second PUC, the more weightage for calculus. Actually, your PUC board examination for 100 marks. 100 marks. Out of these 100 marks, almost 75 marks. 75 marks from only calculus. 75 marks from only calculus. So that much important. And this complete calculus included in only second PUC. That is also very important. So you are going to study complete fundamentals along with most number of concepts, tough concepts only in second PUC. But in first PUC, algebra, geometry, some parts of trigonometry included. That's it. Next, To understand the PU syllabus, PU mathematics syllabus, to solve the problems, we want some basics, few basics which are already included in 7th, 8th, 9th, 10th only. Very basics. If you are very thorough, for example, some students, every student know that A plus B whole square formula that is included in 6th class. 6th class, for example, what is A plus B whole square, A whole square, plus 2AB plus B square. Everyone said that. But when we give simple application of this formula, simple application means, for example, root 5 plus root 3 whole square, almost all, 70% of the students will commit mistake to write this value. Yes, only 30% of the people will write exact answer of root 5 plus root 3 whole square. It's very simple. We know the A plus B whole square. What about A and B? Two real numbers. A and B may be two real numbers. So A plus B whole square is equal to A square plus 2AB plus B square. So very simple. Here, replace A with root 5, B with, in place of B, how much is there? Root 3 on right hand side of the formula. That's it. First one is A square plus 2AB plus B square. Application is important thing. You see, don't by heart the subject of mathematics. A square, A, here A only, but here in place of A, how much is there? Root 5. So A square plus 2AB, 2 into A into B. What is A here? What is A here? Root 5. Yes, what is B? What is B here? Root 3 plus B square. Here B is there, but in place of B here, how much is there? Root 3. That's it. A square plus 2 into A into B plus B square. That's it. Application over. Now simplify. Square and square root get cancelled, and it is 5 plus 2 into what is root 5 into root 3? Root A into root B. Again, that is another formula. Inserts root A into root B can be written as root AB. Yes, so root B can. So root of A into B, 3 into 5, 15. Yes, plus root 3 whole square. Square and root get cancelled, 3. Now we can add like terms. Like terms. 5 plus 3, 8 plus 2 into root 15. That's it. This is the value of root 5 plus root 3 whole square. Some students again do mistake here, commit mistake here. 8 plus 2, 10. They will write 10 root 5. Random mistake. We cannot add these two. This is a third. This is an integer, rational number. We cannot add. This is simple application of A plus B whole square. And A minus B whole square. Simply, 2a term is only the negative. A square minus 2ab plus b square. Then what is the value of root 5 minus root 3 whole square? It is very simple. Only 2ab term is the negative. That's it. So, you should be very thorough in formula. Then, not only thorough in formula, applying the formula in a particular case, particular step, that is also important, and getting the answer is also important. If you not get answer, no problem, but your steps are very important. Some students will by heart the subject. It is not like a theory subject to by heart. You can by heart Kannada, English, or Hindi, whatever it is, but we cannot by heart mathematics. We will go concept wise. Almost 95% of the problems can be solved by applying either concept or formula. Only 5% of the problems are depends upon reasoning. For example, it is a reasoning. It is the square. It has four sides. And we can add. Yes, you take one more square. It has four sides. You take one more square, it has 4 sides, total 4 plus 4 plus 4, 12 sides are there, 12 straight lines, add 3 more sides, 1, 2, 3. Then how much? Total 15 are there. 15 lines are there. 15 straight lines, yes. Total 15 lines are there. You can eliminate, my question is, you can eliminate any 6. You can eliminate any 6. Tell me. 15 minus 6. Generally write 9. I'm telling you that 15 minus 6 is not 9. It is 10. 15 minus 6 is not 9, 10. But I want 10. How? You can eliminate any 6. Any 6 from these all 15 sides. So that you get that 10, not 9. You can try it and see. 1. Eliminated 1. 2. 3. 3 eliminated. 4. 5. 6. So 15 minus 6 is not 9, 10. You are not this point. 15 minus 6 is 9. But here we are, 10. The reasoning, this reason where we did not use any formula or concept or any note point. So like the reasoning arithmetic is also very important for like bank exams. IAS, IPS, reasoning arithmetic, that is very important thing. Just to come back. Simple things. We will discuss simple things in see. For example, first one is natural numbers. Natural numbers. What is the definition of the natural numbers? Listen, listening skills also important. What is the definition of the natural numbers? Almost 50% of the students will start at 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 1. What is my question? What is the definition of natural numbers? You are telling that 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 1 is the example of a natural number. What is the definition of natural number? Definition of the natural number is different. Writing the example is the different. What is the definition of the natural number? Yes. The collection of, we are collecting, we are counting, we are collecting. The collection of all counting numbers. Counting. The collection of all counting numbers is called the natural numbers. Example 1, 2, 3, 4 up to 1. The collection of counting numbers is called the natural number set. We say set. This set theory is the first topic in your first PSC syllabus, mathematics syllabus. We are going to start the same topic, first topic, set theory. It is very easy actually. Sets denoted by capital letters, a single capital letter. Your natural number set, first letter N. So we will write here capital N, natural number set. And we will keep these all natural numbers in flower bracket. This is the notation of, denotation of set, notation of the set, flower bracket. And every set is denoted by a single capital letter. Here we will use N. Here N indicates what? Natural numbers. And next, how many natural numbers are included or involved in this set? 1, 2, 3, 4, only 4? No, up to 1. 1 means infinite. So, infinite number of counting numbers. Infinite number of naturals. Infinite number of naturals. Next. Next. Whole numbers. Next. Whole numbers. What is the definition of whole numbers? Once again, 50-60% of the students will start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So, what is the definition of the whole numbers? First of all, that is important. The collection of all counting numbers. Generally, you start the counting from 1, right? Yes. All the counting numbers, including 0. Including 0. 0 is also. Actually, 0, we cannot include natural numbers. Why? Because generally, we start counting from 1 only. But here, we can include 0 in whole number set. That is a different definition. Whole number set. So, what are the numbers in whole number set? 0. Along with all natural numbers. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to 1. And we will keep these all numbers in flower bracket. There is a set denotation, notation, and the set is denoted by a single capital letter. Here natural number set is denoted by capital N. Whole number set, the first letter W. So we will write capital W, capital letter, single capital letter. Whole number set. Now we compare these two sets, natural number set and whole number set, which is the bigger one. Obviously whole number set, why? Because this set contains at least one extra element that is not included in the natural number set, right? Then immediately we will write, see, this is a new thing for you. N is subset of whole number set. What is the meaning of this sub part? We say sub part, partition, like that. Subset. Natural number set is the, this is the symbol of subset of whole numbers. What is the definition? This is a new thing for you, new definition. This is included in VUC, not in 10th or 9th. Yes, what is the definition of the subset? For example, A is the one set which is the collection of first three natural numbers in the 1, 2, 3. Yes, next. B is the collection of first 5 natural numbers, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, then which is bigger one? B. So it's very clear, A is the subpart of B. That means A is the subset of B. Definition is every element of A lies in B, then A is the subset of B. But here every element of B known into lie does not belong to A, but every element of A lie in set B. Okay, A is the sub. For example, the collection of people, those who are living in Chitradurga, is the collection of all the people, those who are living in Karnataka. Chitradurga is the sub part of Karnataka. Karnataka is the sub part of the country in India. Subset. So every element of A lies in B. That is why A is subset of B. Here, every natural number lies in whole number set, and this whole number set contains one extra element, that is 0. That's why we will write one more point by using these two definitions. N is subset of whole number set. Yes, next, natural number set, whole numbers, next, integers, next, rationals, next, irrationals, next, real numbers, you know, the up to real numbers, I think, that means, real number set is the bigger set. Every 10th class students will say that real number set is the bigger one. No, one more set is there, which is bigger than real number set, that is, complex numbers. For example, in quadratic equation, every quadratic equation has two roots. The two roots can be formed by using factorization method or formula. What is the formula to find factors of quadratic equation? Minus b plus r minus square root of b square minus 4ac by 2a. If this b square minus 4ac, discriminant value is less than 0, then the quadratic equation has roots, two roots, which are imaginary, not real, you can say. The imaginary numbers, collection of all imaginary numbers is called the complex numbers. So, least one, naturals, whole numbers, integers, rationals, irrationals, real numbers, and next one, complex numbers. So, we will discuss one by one. So, two things completed, natural numbers and whole numbers. Next class, we will continue these all fundamentals. Thank you.